What if you stayed in bed forever? There it is, that groggy but universal feeling when your early morning alarm hits, and it's time to start the day. Most of us can relate to not wanting to get out of bed, preferring to stay relaxed in our warm and cushiony cocoon, content to sleep the day away. But you can have too much of a good thing. This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, what if you stayed in bed forever? Are you a fiend for facts? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one and ring the bell for more fascinating content? On a small scale, the majority of us have already experienced the effects of oversleeping, at least to some degree. We spend a third of our lives asleep, and this is normal. But there are also those particular times, like on a Monday morning before a busy week perhaps, when we try to sneak just a little bit more sleep than usual. And often on these days, we experience some short-term effects of extended bed rest. Have you ever found that comfy spot and felt relaxed enough to sleep 8, 9, 10, or more hours of your day away? Afterwards, do you remember any head or muscle aches? Perhaps a feeling of soreness in your lower back and joints? Don't worry, you're not alone, because these are the earliest symptoms and signs that you've been dozing for too long. Whenever we spend longer than usual tucked up in bed, it can affect our blood flow and muscle health in a big way. So say you were laid up for a week. Some of those muscles that aren't being used can lose 10 to 15% of their strength, and over longer periods of time, they'll only continue to weaken. Extended time beneath the sheets can also cause bed sores to develop, which aren't at all pretty. Also known as pressure ulcers, they occur when certain parts of the body don't receive the proper level of blood flow, thanks to an undue amount of pressure in that region. Bed sores start out as red, blotchy patches on your skin, but as they get worse, the skin gets thinner and more fragile, potentially resulting in wet, open wounds and blisters. The most extreme cases of bed sores have even been known to harm the muscle and bone underneath the skin, as part of deep tissue damage. The immediate effects of uninterrupted bed rest don't stop at the skin and muscles either. An extended period of ongoing stasis also decreases the body's endurance. Anyone who gets a lot of cardiovascular exercise knows how brutal and exhausting it can be to go running for the first time after taking a break from the sport. Now imagine the difficulties you'd have if you hadn't even left your bed for, say, a month. The depleted muscle mass, damaged skin, and decreased fitness would make performing even the simplest tasks so much more difficult. This hasn't stopped people from pushing their luck, though, as proved by the various examples of bed rest studies conducted by organizations like NASA. Back in 2014, Andrew Iwanicki made headlines when he was paid $18,000 for a 70-day bed rest study, before writing about the experience for Vice. But Andrew was just one of over 50 people who volunteered for that particular study, and there have been lots more since. The purpose behind these studies is usually to examine how long-term weightlessness could affect astronauts when on prospective deep space missions, or during long-term residency at a space station. Volunteers spend their time in bed with their heads angled downwards at 6 degrees, but they must do all of their normal daily activities while in this position. Eating, reading, showering, and even going to the bathroom all must take place from the bed, all while participants are in constant interaction with scientists testing their muscle responses, fluid levels, mood, and emotions. The fluid levels are particularly important. It doesn't matter how comfortable you feel, any sort of extended bed rest will adversely affect blood flow throughout the body, prompting not only bed sores but also severe problems with your heart. Symptoms of severely hampered blood circulation can include cramping, tingling, or numbness, while blood clots can break away from places like your legs and move to the heart, potentially causing a heart attack or stroke. In Andrew's case, dramatic changes to his circulation made it difficult for him to even stand once his 70 days were up. If a person were to remain in bed forever, the immense circulation issues could eventually lead to them developing conditions such as peripheral artery disease or atherosclerosis, both of which can be fatal. In terms of just generally how you'd physically feel, previous bed rest experiments have led their subjects to describe a sensation as though their veins were elastic, so there's also that. And remember, most of what we do know comes from controlled case studies like these, carried out in the name of science, where there's at least a semblance of safety for everyone involved. If you really did choose to stay in bed forever, then there'd be no cutoff point for the physical changes you could go through. So without at least some sort of bed-bound exercise routine to ensure correct circulation, the problems could get worse and worse. This also isn't taking into account the intense mental and emotional strain such an experience might place upon a person. The European Space Agency teamed up with NASA in March 2019, for more sleep studies, this time calling for 12 men and 12 women to volunteer for a 60-day experiment in exchange for $19,000. The 24 subjects would be, once again, under constant examination by scientists, and this particular study reportedly sees them spend some time in a centrifuge to gain an even greater insight into what life as an astronaut is like. But aside from the high-tech backdrop, there's also an increasing emphasis on monitoring the psychological strain and experiences that extended rest can cause. It's believed that there are links between feelings of isolation, depression, and a tendency to stay in bed, so it's feared that extended rest, or perhaps extended space travel, could exacerbate situations to a dangerous and potentially life-threatening level. So these studies also work toward understanding how best to limit these negative effects. Although the human body is very adaptable, the stories of those who have, either voluntarily or otherwise, experienced long-term bed rest are enough for us to assume that doing so forever would eventually kill us, with the risks rising as we aged. Even if we were young and healthy enough at the onset to withstand bed sores and blood flow issues, we'd all eventually grow older and more susceptible to various physical problems. Our body would literally break down, weakening much more quickly because of a dramatic decline in any physical activity. From there, we'd be at increased risk of developing potentially deadly skin, muscle, or bone conditions, neurological problems, gastrointestinal failure, and/or cardiovascular disease. And even if we avoided all of those, there'd still be a heightened possibility of lapsing into dementia, mania, or a deep and potentially fatal depression. Hitting the snooze button 2 or 3 times isn't going to kill you. Similarly, bed rest is an essential part of the recovery process for lots of diseases and injuries, diagnosed by thousands of doctors and nurses on a daily basis. But it, like everything else, can be taken to a dangerous extreme. And that's what would happen if you stayed in bed forever. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.